First, let's look at how we can reduce the overhead in marshaling the arguments and the data copying. Just to jog your memory, marshaling refers to the fact that the semantics of the RPC call being made between the client and the server is something that the operating system doesn't have any clue about. So in other words, the arguments that are actually passed between the client and the server has semantic meaning only between the client and the server. The operating system has no knowledge of it. And therefore, marshaling is the term that is used to say, let's accumulate all of the arguments that is there in the call and make one contiguous network packet out of it so that we can give it to the kernel and the kernel can send it out. That's what is being described as marshaling. And the biggest source of overhead in marshaling is the data copying that's going to happen. And I'll explain that in a minute. Potentially, in doing the marshaling, there could be three copies involved. Where are these three copies coming about? Well, first of all, the client is executing. When a client is executing a procedure, all the arguments for the procedure call that it wants to do is living on the stack of the client. And there is an entity, we've introduced this terminology even before, called the client stub. And the role of the client stub is to take the arguments of the call which are living on the stack and convert it into a contiguous sequence of bytes called an RPC message. So the RPC message has no semantic meaning. It is just a contiguous string of bytes which you can pass to the kernel, and the kernel can then send it out on the wire, just like any other message. So that's the first thing that the stub does, and that's the first source of overhead. The client stub is making the first copy from the stack in order to create an RPC message. Now remember that the client is a user program, so it is living in the user space outside the kernel, and so this RPC message, which has been created by the stub, it is part of the client's address space, which is living outside the kernel. So this RPC message is in user space, and the kernel has to make a copy of the RPC message from the user space into its own buffer, the kernel buffer. And that's the second source of overhead, the second source of copy in doing the marshaling of the arguments. So now it is in the buffer of the operating system kernel. Now the operating system can kick the network controller and say, hey, go ahead, take this buffer, send it out on the wire to the desired destination. And the network controller at that point is going to move the bits from this buffer, which is in the system memory of the operating system, into its internal buffer using DMA. And this is the third copy that is happening. The copy that is done by the network controller using DMA to move the bits of the RPC message copied from the user space into the internal buffer of the kernel. And now this movement is being orchestrated by the hardware to move it from the kernel buffer into the internal buffer of the network controller so that it can then get out on the wire. So those are the three copies involved in marshaling the arguments of the call before it can be put out on the wire. And the copying overhead is the biggest source of overhead for RPC latency. Now, how do we reduce the number of copies? Well, it turns out that the third copy that you're looking at here, moving the bits from the system memory into the network controller, this is a hardware action, and this is unavoidable, and therefore, we're going to live with it. Unless the network controller is completely redesigned, if the network controller is saying, well, I need to DMA the bits from the system memory into my buffer, well, I have to DMA the bits from the system memory into my internal buffer before I can put it out on the wire, then this third copy is inevitable, so we live with it. But we would like to see if we can try to reduce the number of copies involved here. The first idea is, can we eliminate this copy that is done by the client stub? Why is that happening? Well, it has to create a network message in order to send it out on the wire. As we said, that the semantics of this call is only known to the client and the server, and the client stub is taking the arguments and making a network packet out of it, and it was doing it in user space. And so what we're going to do is we're going to marshal it directly into the kernel buffer. In other words, we've now moved this stub, the client-side stub, from the user space down into the kernel. If we can move it into the kernel, then from the stack, the stub can directly marshal it into the kernel buffer. And so that intermediate copy that we had here, creating an RPC message and copying it again into the kernel buffer is avoided if the stub can directly work on the stack and write it into the kernel memory. So what this means is that at instantiation time, the client stub is installed inside the kernel at bind time. When the client binds with the server at the bind time, what we're going to do is we're going to say that here is the client stub. Please put it inside the kernel so that later on you can use that in order to do the marshaling. So the synthesized procedure is installed in the kernel for each client call. So for each client-server relationship, we synthesize a procedure, which is the client stub, install it in the kernel for use every time I make this call. This stub can be invoked to convert the arguments that are living on the stack into a network message and directly put it into the kernel buffer. So this obviously will eliminate from the two copies down to one copy, because the intermediate copy of converting the arguments into an RPC message is now eliminated. Now the problem with this idea is that we are saying, let's dump some code into the kernel, and that may not be something that is so palatable. So this is a solution that's possible if the RPC service that is being provided between the client and the server is a trusted service, and therefore we can trust who is putting the stub into the kernel. In that case, this solution may be a reasonable one to adopt.